Welcome to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Ottman. On December 6th, 2023, MTSU welcomed Derek Mason as our new head football coach. The former Vanderbilt head coach and ESPN analyst joins us to talk about the blue-collar work ethic he's working to create, as well as the energy and passion for the fans and the game he wants his players and coaches to bring to the program.
Thank you for having me.
It's an honor to have you on the show, and we were talking about this before we got started. It's not your first time in a television studio, right?
Not my first time. You know, this past year was fun. ESPN was a good run. It was a great opportunity for me to learn what happens and behind the scenes, behind the camera. But I'm much more comfortable as a coach, so I think I'll stay in my lane.
Well, you did a great job on television. You're going to do a great job as our coach.
Thank you.
I want to talk about that announcement day when you came out, and you know, here you were on campus, probably the first time you'd ever been on in our student union building.
Right.
All of those emotions that kind of came to play. What was going through your head, the messages that you wanted to leave with our fans on your introduction to them?
You know, that day came and went, you know, quickly. I think it was a blur, but it was a moment for me, man, where I really had thought about the opportunity and what I wanted to say to our fan base and to our medium, right? It had everything to do with how I saw MTSU and my thoughts for this program, a program that has good bones, okay? It's had good bones. It has good bones. When you start to talk about foundation of programs, anytime you have a head coach who's here for 18 years, I think that speaks to the idea that a lot of things were done right during that time. And, you know, like for me, like coming into this space, it was a new opportunity, a great chance for us to sort of reinvent ourselves. You know, as I've looked at MTSU and thought about MTSU, that day for me was very surreal. The idea of stepping into Blue Raider Nation and talking to that group about what we wanted to be, which was blue collar, understanding that like the opportunity to compete for a Conference USA title was something that we were going to be steadfast about. But really what we wanted to do was embrace Rutherford County, embrace Middle Tennessee, embrace the idea of who we are, how we recruit, and really just looking to give our fan base, you know, this strong idea of what my values were to student athletes and to the university, which was the idea of graduating, the idea of making sure that we gave a better product back to parents than the one they drop off. I think that was, you know, like, those are strong statements, but I think those are the statements that I believe I've hung my hat on over the last, you know, like 30 years of coaching. And so to be like in that moment to speak to this fan base, man, it was surreal.
It was an amazing atmosphere. You talked about blue collar.
Yeah.
This edition of MTSU Magazine that just hit the stands. You talk a lot about that mentality. Can you talk to our viewers about what that means? What do you mean by that blue collar drive and intensity?
When I say blue collar, I mean, it takes me, and not just the color blue, and even though
it works.
I'm talking about like understanding Murfreesboro. I mean, it's a working class town. I mean, it's a town that's been built on hard work, blue-collar education, you know, first-gen students, like the understanding that there's work to be done. And I tell our student-athletes, every day is a job interview. And I mean, you have a new opportunity every day to meet somebody, to make an impact. The opportunity to be different has to do with the work that you do. We're going to work hard every day. And so I wanted that to be, you know, part of like what I talked about with our student athletes, but I truly believe it's part of the DNA, okay, like of what MTSU is. I mean, this is a place where the work gets done, okay, across many, you know, academic, you know, educational opportunities, but also like in sports. When you look at this place and what it's been and what it's been able to do, you know, it sits amongst the group of five schools, like in a way where it can make its mark, but it's never going to make its mark in the way that others do. It's going to be about the work that we do in between the white lines, like in the classroom and what we do in the weight room. I mean, like all these things sort of matter, and it gives us like this identity that we can hang on to that allows us to like truly invest in what we say we are. I mean, if we're going to be blue collar, it's going to be about the work, and our work has to be intentional. So let's just be about the work.
I think it's phenomenal. You referenced our first generation college students. We're number one choice of students seeking that kind of opportunity in Tennessee. It really fits in. So you and I met, really got to know each other for the first time at the Christmas parade, the Murfreesboro Christmas parade.
That's right.
So we'd never really had a chance to kind of talk about how that was going to go. You just show up and, you know, we don't know how Coach is going to be comfortable. We got a pickup truck for him. We got a chair in the back of the pickup. We want Coach to be safe. We don't want to be the people that injured Coach on his first couple of days.
Right.
You weren't in that chair but 2 minutes.
Right.
Talk about how you jumped out of the truck and you connected with those people, and what did you learn talking to those folks?
Well, like, to me, it could be sterile, being in a parade and just sitting in the back of a truck and just waving. I mean, that's not really who I am. Mm-hmm. And so, and halfway through, I saw a little girl, and she was waving, and she had her hand up, and she was waving hard. She had on her MTSU, like, jacket, and, you know, man, she was bundled up, and, you know, I just said, hey, like, why don't I jump out and just reach out and say hello to this little girl? But, I mean, it really became more than that. Jumped out and said hello to, you know, several folks. You know, one became two became 10 became 300,
it
right?
It was crazy.
And all we did was just, like, high five and hug and say hello. But, like, to me, like, that was a middle moment.
Oh,
like, for me, it was more about me stepping out and understanding that, you know what? If you love this place will love you back, mm-hmm. right? And so, like, having the opportunity to get out of the truck and just connect. You know, people said hello. People said, hey, Coach, like, glad to have you here. You know, going to be at the games, going to renew, you know, I mean, our tickets. And we're going to win. We're going to have success. You know, that's energy. And I think energy begets energy. So just a simple act of stepping out of a truck, okay, man, and being able to just shake a hand, give a hug, say hello. I mean, allow me to connect with them and them to connect with me. So now I feel like we're all one in the same.
Well, Coach Mason, great to have you on the program. I got to ask you one last thing.
Please.
Spring game, you think we'll have one?
It's coming. It's coming. Yeah, April 13th. We haven't defined what the time will be, but we do know that date for sure. And I'm excited. We're going to have a spring game, and offense versus defense, let's let it rip.
That's going to be so exciting for our fans.
It will be.
To get to know you and get to know this team. And, of course, you can read more about Coach in the latest edition of MTSU Magazine. Coach Mason, thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.